Good morning and welcome to this weekly macro and strategy update. Today, I will focus on the ongoing Brexit issue. While this subject is less covered than the US elections, the lack of agreement between the UK and the EU could have adverse effects on markets. Last week, UK Prime Minister Johnson threatened once again to slam the door to further Brexit talks unless the EU offers fundamental changes to the deal. Both parties thus let the first official deadline for a post-Brexit agreement pass in mid-October, just before the summit of the European Council. Looking at economic activity, GDP data showed that momentum was already slowing in August, with all sectors still well below their previous peaks. GDP will have to rebound by 8% in September to meet the latest Bank of England projections. Adding to that renewed restriction due to the second wave of the COVID-19, a rising unemployment rate and stalling Brexit negotiations, the outlook remains bleak. Our main scenario is a last-minute deal in late November. But let's be clear, the only real deadline is the end of the transition period on the 31st of December, and uncertainty will remain high until late November due to negotiation tactics. For financial markets, risks are asymmetric. A positive outcome on the Brexit is unlikely to push equity markets and the pound sterling much higher given underlying fundamentals, while a no deal would be an extra blow to one of the weakest markets here to date. Inflation would also rise due to FX depreciation and the tariff effects. In our allocation, we remain underweight on UK equities and on the pound, and we are overweight UK gilts in anticipation of lower yields. Thank you for listening and see you next week.